and welcome to Pure Experiences. All that which is existence. The whole, the complete, the greatest is the existence. It is the only one. There are no two existences and there is no non-existence. The existence is eternal, timeless and infinite. There is nothing else except this one existence. It is empty. It is devoid of substance. It is an ocean of possibilities. It's almost dreamlike. It is there, but it is not what it seems to be. This ocean of possibilities, infinite number of them, appears in the form of an experience. Experience is that which appears. This is how we know that there is an existence. This is how we see the manifested existence. Because of the infinite potential, the experiences are also infinite. There are uncountable numbers of experiences and there can be many varieties or categories of experiences. Without experiences, there won't be any knowledge of any kind of existence of anything. What happens when the appearances disappear? When the experience disappears, is it non-existence? That will be a difficult question because now the existence is undefined. The experience of non-existence is impossible. The experience is always of something. And that is why it is always there. That to which the existence appears as experiences is the experiencer. It is that elusive part of existence which is not an experience. But it does not lie outside the existence. There are not many existences. Everything is, by definition, within existence. But without the experiencer, we'll never know the experience and we'll never know the existence. Yet, it cannot be experienced in any form. It is not an object. That means it cannot be known. It cannot be known as an experience of any kind. But it is there because the experiences are being known. There is no experience which is devoid of the experiencer. It is the knower. And it is somehow exactly opposite of the experience. Experiences are of infinite variety. Experiencer is only one. It is empty. It is devoid of all qualities. Experience is changing, never the same. Experiencer is unchanging. It's always the same. Because there are infinite experiences, they are timeless. The experiencer is also eternal and timeless. Because there is no limit to experiences, the experiencer also does not see any limits. It is infinite also. In a strange way, there are no boundaries to the experiencer. Since there is only one existence, it seems that these two categories of the experience and the experiencer are an unnecessary division. The existence is the experience and the existence is the experiencer. And this is how we see it actually. We see the existence as a dynamic presence. We never see the experience without the experiencer. And we never see the experiencer without any experience. When these divisions are not made, there is just this alive presence of existence witnessing itself in the form of experiences. Here there are no concepts and no knowledge is required. Here there are not two. It is a non-dual state. We can call it experiencing in simple words. But it is not an action. It is a presence. Nobody is doing it. The varieties of experiences, the time, the space, the bodies, the mental concepts such as I, the doer, the known, the unknown, the true, the false, and all the mental activities that rise and fall in experiencing, that are contained in experiencing. How is it even possible that the infinite possibilities in existence are seen by itself? It is possible by limiting itself in the form of a finite structure, which creates an illusion of what is. The illusion is limited, has forms, is in time, is ever-changing, and is non-substantial. It's almost like a dream, but that is how the existence makes itself known to itself in the form of ephemeral, illusory experiences. There is nothing else really. Nothing else is happening. And this happening is almost a non-happening. because of its illusory nature. The existence has no qualities, but it takes on qualities because of the illusion. Just to appear to itself, it must have some qualities. Otherwise, nothing is going to appear. Because of the infinite possibilities, it is happening as a non-happening. The existence, appearing in illusory forms to itself as an experiencer, that is all there is. It is just one very conscious presence in the state of experiencing. The existence is not an object. The experiences are not of objects. The experiencer is not an object. And we cannot say that they are not there. It is a presence. That's all it is. Just an empty presence that appears to have something there, that appears to be moving, evolving in a countless variety of experiences. It is an unfolding that is conscious. It is one. It is right now, right here. The experiencing is right here. And this is the essential knowledge. There's nothing else to know. Whatever you will know after this will be the knowledge of the illusion, concepts, ideas, stories, imaginations. In experiencing, there is no knowledge. The knowledge ends here. There's nothing more to know, except minute details for those who are interested in those minute details. And they are completely unnecessary and useless. What has happened is, we have collected these details. We have created castles in the air. And that is why the simple looking is occluded. This darkness is also called the ignorance. And there is a way to dispel this darkness. It is the path of knowledge. The path of knowledge is the direct path or the pathless path, which takes you here where we are right now in the experiencing. In other words, it brings you back home. This eternal experiencing is my home. The path of knowledge destroys the ignorance. It does not give you anything extra over and above that which is right here, right now, the existence experiencing itself. It brings you back here. If you're already here, if you're already home, then the rest of the series is a total waste of time for you. You will learn nothing and you will know nothing. The path of knowledge is for those who are lost, who don't know where their home is. Knowledge is like a lighthouse that shows them the way. Those who could understand what I just said with the help of these three concepts of the existence, the experience, and the experiencer, and the combination of all the experiencing, they need not even watch the whole series that we are starting now. Except if they are curious or interested. Sometimes it is just entertaining to retrace our footprints back home. In that way, you can enjoy this series. But the whole discussion is meant for those who are still in duality, who are still lost in their own mind, who are in the grip of the illusion. That which follows will clear this ignorance and bring them back here. So if you're ready, we can start with the next part. Remember that this is all there is. There's nothing more to know. We are at the end right now. This is the whole of the knowledge. Even then, if you are interested, you are most welcome. And I'll introduce you to the path of knowledge in the next part of this series. Thank you very much for listening.